This is what you get by the end of this AllStore download tutorial, along with installing AllStore on Mac. I have shown the signing and re-signing of the apps on AllStore Mac. Let's just start this video. In this AllStore Mac download tutorial, I am showing you how to download and install AllStore on iPhone running on iOS 18 devices. Although it does work on lower iOS versions as well. As you can see, I am on iOS 18 beta. Just in case you want to install iOS 18 beta, I already have made tutorial on that. I will link that up in the cards and in the description below. You can also downgrade it so that if you don't like the iOS 18 beta, all without losing data. You can find that tutorial below as well. Let's start the process to install AllStore iOS 18 on Mac. First, we need to download AllServer for Mac from AllStore official website. Open Safari browser or any other browser and go to the allstore.io website. From here, you need to download the Mac OS version of the AllServer. Click on the Mac button and it will start downloading. Guys, if you want AllStore Windows tutorial, let me know in the comments below. Once the AllServer is downloaded, click on the Downloads arrow at the top right corner of the browser and double click on the downloaded file. Once you click the AllServer file, your computer will first verify it. After the verification, a dialog box will open stating AllServer is an app downloaded it from the internet. Are you sure you want to open it? Just click on the open. Just after a few seconds, you will see the AllServer icon at the top right corner of your Mac screen. You can see that here. Now I will show you how to install AllStore iOS 18 on iPhone through the Mac computer. Before that, if you are new to my channel, hit the like and the subscribe button for more iOS related videos. Connect your device with the computer and make sure your iPhone is connected to the same Wi-Fi network as the computer. Hit the trust button on the pop-up on your iPhone or iPad. Now to get AllStore on iPhone, click on the AllServer icon at the top. There, you will see the option to install AllStore. Hover your mouse pointer on it. It will show your device's name. Click on it. It will ask you for Apple ID credentials. Sign in with the Apple ID that already logged on your connected device and click on the install button. Your Apple ID will be used to sign or re-sign the applications with the AllStore. Guys, if you have two-factor authentication enabled for your Apple ID, you need to enter the code when logging in from your computer for verification purposes. A pop-up with the code will appear on your device when you turn on your device's screen. Put that code in the dialog box on your computer and proceed. Just in case the pop-up does not appear on your device, let me just show you how you can get the verification code. This is the problem people sometimes face. They cannot log in with Apple ID on their computer or anywhere else without code. Go to the settings, tap on your Apple ID. Here, tap on password and security. It will ask you for the authentication. Do it. On the next screen, tap on this Get Verification Code button. It will show you a pop-up with the code. In this video, the pop-up isn't showing because of the security. Put the code on your computer screen and click on the install button. The AllStore Mac will start installing on your device. It could take a few seconds to install AllStore iOS 18 on your iPhone. Let me put my device on the side as well so you can see it. In case you see any error during the AllStore iOS 18 installation on the iPhone, all you need to do is repeat the installation process. And if you see a pop-up stating AllStore is already installed on another device, just click on the continue. As you can see on my device, the AllStore iOS 18 Mac is successfully installed. If I click on the AllStore icon on my device, it will show me an untrusted developer pop-up. This means I need to trust the AllStore before I use it. For that, go to the settings. Then go to the general, tap on VPN and device management, tap on the Apple ID and trust the application. After that, you will be able to open the alt store. As you can see, just go through the initial setup. The alt store is working fine. Now I will show you how to install apps with alt store iOS 18 on iPhone. In the alt store, you can directly download the Delta GPA for iOS application, which is built in the alt store. If you tap on the get button, it will ask you to put in your Apple ID and password. Here, you need to put the same Apple ID and password you put in on your computer while installing the alt store on your iPhone. After that, it will start downloading the Delta app on your device. Now I will show you how to install apps with alt store iOS 18 on your iPhone or iPad. You need to have an IPA file to install on the device. I have downloaded the Uncover Jailbreak IPA file already. Let's just install Uncover Jailbreak with alt store. Guys, before you go ahead and install any app, make sure your device is connected to the computer and your device and computer are on the same Wi-Fi network. Make sure these things first and then proceed. Open the alt store and tap on My Apps, then tap on the plus icon at the top of your device. This page will show you all the downloaded IPA files you have that you can install with the alt store. Just tap on the file and it will start installing on your device. If you are installing the app for the first time with alt store, it will ask you to put in your Apple ID and password, put in the credentials and proceed. It will start installing the app on your device. At this point, the reason it did not ask me to put in the Apple ID is that I already put in while downloading the Delta application. Here you can see Uncover is installed on my device. This is how to install apps with alt store on iPhone or iPad. Now, the last thing I'm going to show you is how to re-sign the apps with alt store. As you can see on the My Apps section, it states 7-day expiry. The installed apps will expire after 7 days on a free developer account. However, you get 1 year of the signed apps on alt store if you have a paid developer account. Let's just suppose there is only 1 day left for the apps to expire here. Now you need to re-sign them to keep them working on your device. Now, first you need to attach your device to the computer from where you installed the alt store on your device. Make sure the connected device and computer are on the same Wi-Fi network. Also make sure the alt server is running on your computer. Now, tap on this refresh all button on your device. The expiration date will reset back to the 7 days. This is how to install alt store iOS 18 on iPhone and macOS with Mail plugin. If you face any issues, comment below so I can help you out. Thank you for watching.